Hello everyone, and welcome to Couples Kitchen. Today we'll make some fish soup. To prepare this meal, you will need 1.5 tablespoon of dried vegetables. They are finely chopped, but they have salt in it. On Serbian they call it vegeta. And also we'll need again 1.5 tablespoon of dried chopped vegetables. You have everything there, carrots and other stuff. Also we will need 1 big onion, 4 medium sized carrots, 4 cloves of garlic, 4 bay leaves, 1 fresh sweet paprika and 1 fresh hot paprika, 1 shallot, 1 teaspoon of dried parsley leaf, 30 grams of parsley root. You will also need 3 very hot chili peppers. Don't let their size fool you, they're straight from hell. And a little bit of dill and celery. That you must decide, will you put it or not, that's optional. And a little bit of black pepper, but they are in grains, about 7 grains. 100 milliliters of diced tomato, 2 tablespoons of powdered paprika or grounded, very fine grounded paprika. You will also need to dine the onions, to dine everything up. You will need some salt, some olive oil and ordinary oil, I mean sunflower oil, and that's it. And today I'm gonna be your chef because my wife doesn't like fish. Fish that we're gonna use is the fresh salmon. This is the leftovers of the salmon because we filleted the whole fish, and these are the leftovers. This is the bottom part of the belly. This have a lot of fat, so it's gonna be good for the fish soup. This is a leftover of tail, spine, head and a little bit of bones. So this is optional fish. In Serbia traditionally are made, the fish soup is traditionally made from carp, catfish or some other river, you know, or lake fish. First thing, you will need to chop down the onion. Doesn't need to be very thin chopped, but not also so very big. This one is running away. And when you are done doing that, you will need to chop everything out. The white, the garlic, the shallot, the paprika, and you will need to grind the carrots. The two you can grind, the two you can cut in little pieces. So the first thing you're gonna do is put the fish in some kind of pot. Okay, and then you add water and let it cook about, I don't know, maybe half an hour to an hour. The next thing we're gonna do is oil our second pot, and this is not going very good. How it's going now. You don't need too much oil, but just to cover the bottom a little bit more. So I about like this much, so it's nice and easy. shove everything in, turn on the heat and then mix it all together. And when it starts frying, you add a little by little water so it gets meshy. It must get pasty. It cannot be so big. So see, this is too big. So it needs to get pasty. So the garlic starts frying. So we're gonna need to dice it. Some water, not much, little by little, so it can fall apart when we added water. We're gonna find the cover for it and let it about and check it every, I don't know, approximately 2-3 minutes. So if you need to add water, you're gonna add a little bit more water, mix it and repeat. The onion started to soften and to fall apart. So you will add some bay leaf and some green pepper in it. And again, if see, it needs water, so I will add a little bit of water and again simmer it and until everything falls apart. So it started to fall apart. See, it's like it started to make some liquids, and then that liquid gonna be like a paste, and then you will continue to the next step. And when fish get cooked, you're gonna need to separate the meat from the bones. And then you filter the water in another pot, and then you will put it in this one later. So this is the water that we have, that fish was cooking in it. So we're gonna leave that to sit there, and this is about finished paste of onions and everything else. We're gonna start adding our other ingredients. First we're gonna add our powdered paprika and dried and grounded vegetables. These ones are with salt. So we're gonna need to mix it all together so it blends and make the low heat on your heat source. So you need to slowly mix it and blend it all together. The next ingredient is diced tomatoes. Mix that. and let it fry a little bit, dine it. Just a little bit, 2 or 3 minutes, nothing more. Just so they combine and let the flavors go and mix. So when that's been done, you're gonna add the dried parsley. I'm gonna start adding everything. This is a dried vegetables. These are the fresh one, carrots, dill and parsley root. I'm gonna add everything up. And then you're gonna add hot and sweet paprika. And mix it all together. And then you're gonna add the filtered water from fish. Just as much you need. You don't need to put everything. But in this case, I don't know, maybe I'm gonna put everything. I am. And then stir it and mix it all together so it blends. Put it on high heat and let it starts really, really intense to boil, and then put it out on low heat or medium heat for a couple of, maybe 1 hour. And I almost forgot our chilies from hell. So we're gonna chop them and put them aside. These are dried chili peppers. You can buy them in stores. And then just don't touch your eyes with this hand or mouth. It's they are very hot. And then mix it all together again. Put it on heat and leave it about an hour. Our stew is doing good. See how it's red and nice. And this is how much of meat I have severed from the head and all other parts that would be usually wasted and thrown away. And then you easily put the meat in pot, but you need to be very careful with this so it doesn't get any bones inside. And now you just let it again for a half an hour to an hour to cook on a medium heat. So it's almost done. And the last step you would need to take is to try it. Is it good? Just try not to hurt yourself. One thing I'm sure, it's definitely hot. Just as need to be. It's hot, but it needs a little bit of pepper. Not much. That's it. And salt. You need to judge how much you will add by yourself. And then simmer it or stir it or however, so the salt melts down and mix with all other ingredients, and leave it for 5 more minutes on low heat, and then it should be done. So I will try it once more so I can be sure is it salty enough. Yep, it's good. So that is it. If you are new around here, consider subscribing or sharing this video. Like is also good. And I hope that you make some good fish stew by yourself. And you can also comment, did I leave something out, or should I put something in? You know, some suggestions. Maybe someone of you already made this maybe even better, or had some problems, so you can comment that, and we will sometimes maybe make again on open fire. But that's in the future, so see you in the next video. We love you, and as always, ciao.